as the pressure increases, it rises. Z becomes greater than 1 eventually. And it becomes 1. You know why it becomes 1? It becomes 1 because the real volume cannot go beyond a certain given volume. That is the volume of the solid. But the ideal volume can approach 0. So that is why V real by V ideal fraction increases very rapidly when the gases are solidified. Okay. Now, I hope you have understood that. We also did the mathematical proofs to prove that Z is less than 1 at pressures, less pressures, first part. And in the second part, when pressure is high, we also proved that Z is greater than 1. Okay. Now, moving forward. I told you that Z is generally less than 1, but not always. Why did I say that? Because for helium and hydrogen, Z is greater than 1 always. Okay. So, these are exceptional. So, why these are exceptional? Because they have very small value of A. What is A? A is van der Waal constant. So, can somebody explain me what is A? What does it signify? Anyone? Come on, let's see. Who remembers? Yes?
Sir.
Go ahead.
Sir, A measures the magnitude of the attractive force between the molecules.
Yes. Yes. Correct. And when we reduce A, the attractive forces between them reduces, and it is difficult to liquefy such gases. That is why, that is the reason hydrogen and helium are very difficult to liquefy. Please write it down, draw this graph, then we'll move forward.
The hydrogen, helium, both are the straight line graph.
It is not a straight line graph. It is basically a curve. But what I am trying to depict is that Z is always greater than 1. This is Z is equal to 1. This dotted line is Z is equal to 1. This is Z is equal to 0. And the graph always remains above 1. The freezing point or the liquefaction of hydrogen. Do you know liquid hydrogen? What is the freezing point? Or no, I should not say freezing point, but liquefaction point. It's very, very less. Minus, I think, 173 or something like that. Have you done? Let me know when you have. Let me know when you have done.
Sir, done.
Okay. Niranjan, done?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Thank
okay.
You.
Okay. So, now, up till now, we have seen only one equation for real gases.
The hydrogen and helium do not show a real gas behavior.
See, they are real gases, but if somebody asks you which real gas is closest to its behavior to ideal gas, although I should not say closest to the behavior also, because ideal gas always have Z is equal to 1, whereas they are having Z is greater than 1, but they are difficult to liquefy. They are real gases. They are real gases, but they are very, very difficult to liquefy. And that is due to the less amount of A. That is the reason. Okay. All right. So, up till now, we have learned only one equation. We have seen only one equation for real gas. And the name of that equation is, please tell me, what is the name of that equation?
Sir, Van der Waal equation.
Yes, it was Van der Waal equation. Now, this is the third, second equation. Although, this equation is not used that much. Also, there is a derivation, but I don't think derivation is important in today's scenario. It was 7-8 years back, we used to tell derivations to everyone. But I think derivation is not important in today's scenario. So, you just mentioned some other equations for real gases. And this is virial equation. So, Z is compressibility factor, you know. Z is equal to PVM by RT. Now, what is VM? VM is the molar volume. So, what is the molar volume? Utkarsh, please tell us what is the molar volume. Yes. Utkarsh?
Yes, sir.
Molar volume. What is molar volume?
No, no, sir.
Charan will tell us.
1 second, sir.
Come on, this is simple.
Just the volume use... of 1 mole.
Yes, very simple. Volume of 1 mole. Okay. Things are not so different. You people are worried. That's why you face a lot of problems. Okay. Don't be in a constant state of worry. Things are easy. Okay. So you are learning it for the first time. That's why it will seem a little typical. But as we will do and as we will practice more questions, the things will become easy. Okay. Okay. So VM is equal to molar volume. P is the pressure, R is the gas constant, you know the values also. Please tell me the value of R. Let's see, who remembers it? Value of R?
0.0082. 0.081.
Now, there are two different values that have been spoken about. 0.082 was said by Daksh. And 0.0082 was said by Utkarsh.
No, sir. 0.082 I said.
Acha. All right. Yes. That is the correct value. Good. Okay. So, apart from that, B. You can say, sir, what is B? So, B is the coefficient of VM. C is coefficient of VM square. D is coefficient of VM cube. Okay. And the value of the coefficients of B, C is given to you. The value of B comes out to be B minus A by RT. Okay. Now, what is B? B was the coefficient. Capital B. Okay. There are two B's here. Capital B is coefficient of 1 by VM. Small b, you know, small b. What is small b? Please tell me, anyone. What is small b?
Sir, sir, volume.
Sir.
Yes, yes. Come on.
The co-volume.
Yes. So first of all, you will say, sir.
The effective volume occupied.
No. You have to explain yourself. Which type of volume is it? So it is the volume occupied by the molecules of the gas. Either you can say that.
Or sir, can we say, sir, volume occupied by the molecule of one mole of gas?
Yes, you can say that. You can say that. Although there is a little problem, let's not discuss that here. Yes, you can say that. And also, please mention that B, small b, is one of the van der Waals constants. Okay, van der Waals constants. There are only two van der Waals constants, A and B. B refers to the volume occupied by the one mole of the gas molecules taken together. And A is also a van der Waals constant, and it denotes or signifies the pressure, the attractive force between the two molecules of the gas. Obviously, it affects the pressure. It reduces the pressure. Okay. So, capital B, coefficient of 1 by Vm. Capital C, coefficient of 1 by Vm square. Okay, just please copy this. Virial equation does not come very often, but I have told you in case you encounter it and you think that. Yes?
Heading.
Heading is this. Some other equation for real gases. One was van der Waal. This is the other one. Although van der Waal is more famous. Why van der Waal is famous? Because it is more simple. And simple things tend to be more famous.
Certain.
All right. Utkarsh, done. Sorry.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you have. I'm so sorry. I wanted to ask Charan and Daksh. Charan, have
sir,
you done?
Done.
Okay, Daksh, you also?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's move forward. Now, we are introducing a temperature known as Boyle's temperature, TB. Now let's see what is the definition of Boyle's temperature. Please write the definition of Boyle's temperature with me. Boyle's temperature, give the heading Boyle's temperature, T small b, and its definition is, let's write temperature at which
behaves like ideal gas.
Yes, a real gas starts behaving as an ideal gas over a particular range of pressure. Over a particular range of pressure. There is the value of TB also. The value of TB is given by A by RB. This is the value. Let me know when you have written. See, the real gases also behave as ideal gases, but not for all ranges of pressures. There are some ranges of pressures in which a real gas can behave as ideal, but as soon as that pressure range is over, it will again start behaving as a real gas. Okay. So, when at a particular temperature, a gas behaves for a very long period of pressure. Okay, it is a very, very long range, not a short range, but very long range. So, so the definition is something like the temperature at which a real gas starts behaving as an ideal gas over a significant range of pressure. Over a particular range, and that particular range should be significant, not very, very small. Okay, a good range. By good range, I mean for a lot of pressures at that particular temperature, that real gas behaves as a ideal gas. That is the Boyle's temperature. Okay, it can be found out by TB is equal to A by RB. Okay, now by these different values TB and all, although we are also going to see some more formulae just now, and then these formulas, there are some today is Daksh's birthday. Daksh, happy birthday.
Thank you, sir.
So how did Utkarsh knew that today is Daksh's birthday?
Last class only he was asking when is your birthday.
Achya. Okay, that is great. All right. Great. So yes. So let's move a little more forward. We are closing. We are coming near to the end of the chapter. The next important thing which we are going to discuss is known as Andrews isotherm. Okay. It is a, also a very, very interesting thing. Let me show you a graph. Okay, let me make a graph for you. What is Andrews isotherm? I'll give you a hint. I'll give you a... Okay, so whenever we make a PV graph for an ideal gas, it comes like this. Please tell me, this is a normal PV graph of any ideal gas. Am I correct? Please tell me. Yes. Ideal gas? Yes, this is a normal PV graph. Okay, PV is equal to constant. It's a rectangular hyperbola. Now, for a real gas, I need to plot the curve. Okay, so Andrews isotherm, Andrew was the first person to plot the curve. He plotted the curve for CO2 gas. CO2 is a real gas. So, I'll teach you how to plot the curve, how to make this curve. Now what you have to do is, step one, what you do, you make this line, PV is equal to constant. Okay, PV is equal to constant, you make this line, assuming ideal behavior. Step two, please focus. Step two, you make a mountain. I'll tell you what I'm saying and why I am saying. You make a mountain touching this curve, PV is equal to constant. Okay, step two is make a mountain with dotted line, of course, make a mountain touching the first curve. Okay, now step three. Now in step three, there will be deviation. Now please observe the deviation. The next curve will not be like this. It will not be like this. By next curve, what do I mean by next curve? I am plotting PV curves for different temperatures, T1, T2, T3, T4, and so on, of varying temperatures. This Andrews isotherm is about the plotting of PV curves for different temperature ranges. Okay. T2 curve will not be plotted as shown in the graph. Let me erase it for you because I have drawn it incorrectly. Now, I will tell you how to draw the next temperature curve. The next curve is interesting like this. Then there will be a constant line, something like this. And then please observe the third part of the curve is something like this. So I have drawn this in three different steps. First, second, and third. Now please try to draw this. Just try to draw this in rough. We'll draw it properly. We'll draw a good graph like this one. This is the final graph we'll draw. But just practice it. I'll tell you why am I teaching you this. Just try to practice it. Step one, draw the normal curve. PV is equal to constant, rectangular hyperbola. Then step two, make a mountain. Dotted lines. Okay. Because mountain finally we'll erase. Mountain has no role here. It only helps us in drawing. That's it. Then step three, draw a lower temperature curve. T2 is lesser than T1. Okay. T1 is greater than T2 or T2 is lesser than T1. Step three, you can say, draw curve in three different parts. In three different parts, as shown. For lower temperature. Just practice in rough or in fair. Utkarsh, are you able to understand, child? How to draw this?
A little bit here.
Okay. Step three is only, I think, a little bit problematic, maybe. Step one and step two are simple. Let me tell you again. Please see. First of all, you draw the axis. P axis, V axis, Then draw step one, draw the rectangular hyperbola. Step two, draw the mountain touching the first graph. Step three, draw the curve in the three different parts. Now you observe these three different parts, how they are to be drawn, like this, and like this, something like this. Okay. Although this line is not straight, the line has to be slanting.
What about the role of mountain?
I'll tell you in a while. Just first practice it. I'll tell you in a while what's the role of the mountain. There is a significance of it. Let's see how well you all have drawn. Who's gonna show us in the camera? Yes.
So what do you have to show?
How well you have drawn this? Let's see how well you have drawn this curve. If anybody has, let's see. Somebody just left.
Sir, Charan.
Charan has left. Okay, he will return. Come on, has anybody drawn? Niranjan, have you?
Sir, I drew the first one. I'm doing the second one.
First means step one. What first?
Sir, like the first diagram.
So first and second both are same. First and second both are same actually. See, you are referring this to first, and this is the second.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
Second
sir.
One I drew again to explain you all. Okay. Those are not two different diagrams, but same. Okay, let's see your diagram. Please show. Okay, wait. Uh-huh. Hold still. No, your mountain is not visible to me. Where is your mountain? Come on, please show me. Come on, who else is showing? No, Niranjan. Your drawing is very, very poor, Niranjan. No. See, the graph should be accurate. Okay. Please observe that you have not made the correct graph. The step two, in step two, one, two, and three parts of step two of that curve, you have not made it correctly. Please observe. Come on, who else is showing? Come on, fast.
Sir, I.
Okay, okay. Yes, let's see, Daksh. Where is your graph? Make your copy a little bit low. Bring the copy a little bit low, low. Okay, wait. Child, your graph is also wrong. What you have done is you have made the first part of the curve in step 2 parallel with the y-axis. It is not parallel with the y-axis. It is not parallel. Also, the part 3 in the step 2 is not the continuation as a straight line, but a little slanting line. Please make it correct. Please make it correctly. Do the changes. Come on, Charan and Nikhil. Fast.
Yes, sir.
Utkarsh, what about you? Have you made Utkarsh? Utkarsh is showing? Where are you, Utkarsh? Hold on. Nahi Utkarsh. Terrible curve, terrible. Not at all a good curve. Please draw. See, you are not making the drawing perfectly. I don't know. You are thinking it's all right to draw anything as a curve. Please observe again. Let me draw it for you again. First of all, axis. Then a rectangular hyperbola. Yes, please. Yes, a Chandikal is showing. Okay, wait, please. Wait. Let's see. Yes. Okay, yeah, Nikhil has maintained the boundaries correctly. He has respected the mountain. He knows where the curve 1 ends, where curve 2 begins, where the curve 3 is beginning. Okay, yeah. It is better. Yes. Okay. Okay, let me draw it again for you and then I'll tell you something interesting about this curve, what we are actually doing. Now, we made a mountain after this, okay, and they should be touching actually. They should be touching. In order to be correct, it should be a tangent at this mountain, this first curve. Okay, after that, the second curve is like this, slant. And then this straight line, almost a straight line, and then again a slant. Okay, so this is curve 1, this is curve 2. Just make it again, and then I'll explain.
Sure.
Yes. Acha, Utkarsh is showing. Wait. Child, your mountain is very, very pointy. Very, very. What should I say?
Meeting is going to end in 2 minutes.
Acha, meeting is going to end. Acha, all right. So you see, you should draw with a little bit accuracy because you see. We have observed that a person who draws with some sort of accuracy also has a good brain. And the person who does not draw with accurately, I am not saying neatly, you can draw without the neatness also, but it should be accurate. The things, the starting, the ending points should be accurate. Okay. Or at least having some accuracy. Okay. So please try to maintain that. Okay. So yes, how much minute is left? How many minutes?
Less than a minute.
20, Okay, okay. Now, who is this? Who is this showing? Achha, Utkarsh is showing again. Is it Utkarsh? Yes. Okay, yes, it is Utkarsh. Yes, now this is somewhat better. This is somewhat better. Yes, yes. All right. All right. Okay. Now, let's end this meeting and then rejoin. And then I'll explain this curve, what is so important about this curve. Okay. Let's rejoin.